5-year-old Agustin Donofrio, Germán Cáceres, Nicolás Ursi, and Luciano Puchetta. Chilean man Benjamin Blake is the sole survivor, tonight in a serious condition in hospital. Their car crashed head-on with a truck near Erua, just north of Ohakune. Sarah Batley's been in the area talking to some of those first at the scene.
The tragic aftermath of a horrific head-on crash that left four Argentinian men dead and a Chilean man fighting for his life. For local emergency services, it was one of the worst crashes they've ever seen.
It's frustrating, it's tragic, it touches the lives of so many people, and it's so unnecessary.
It looked like a bomb had gone off. You know, the accident scene and all the stuff lying around on the road and bits of car everywhere.
Police say it appears the car started overtaking a truck at this point when it became involved in a collision with another truck heading in the opposite direction. They say there wasn't enough room to pass.
There's not 100 metres of clear visibility for anybody throughout the entire passing manoeuvre, which is the rule.
The driver of the truck came to the wrecking yard this morning. Staff say he was very shaken up and told them when he came around the corner last night, he saw the headlights of the car for 2 seconds before it disappeared underneath his truck. This isn't the first time lives have been lost on this exact stretch of road, with 2 people killed here a couple of years ago.
I don't think you can blame the road.
This is the second major crash involving overseas visitors in the region in as many months. 3 Boston University students were killed when their van overturned near Turangi. The 4 victims from last night's crash were all working at the Whakapapa ski field and lived in the National Park area. One of the victims was staying at this backpacker's.
He was a great guy and he was really nice. He will truly be missed, like, terrible loss.
His girlfriend, who's also living here, is being supported by staff.
She was really broken up and, she's probably not doing too well.
Those travelling in the car had just returned from winning an indoor soccer game in Ohakune. Their celebrations and overseas experience cut tragically short. Sarah Batley, One News.